Welcome to the top 10 tips for the design editor. Now let's get started with editing and the navigation panel. The navigation panel is on the right hand side, and here are displayed all the pages for your project. And you can scroll to any page and click on it, and it will zoom the main design editor to that page. So then from here, in the top right corner of every icon or every thumbnail, you can pop up a short menu where you can duplicate pages, add new pages, import or lock a page to prevent accidental design changes of that specific page. And if you need more room in your editor, you can hide the navigation panel and then reopen it again. Similarly, on the left-hand side, this is the panel where all the features for the design editor appear. And you can hide this panel or indeed shrink it to make more room for the actual editing of your ebook. So now let's cover making text changes. Now clicking on any area in the text, the cursor will appear and you can simply type straight away into that text box. So you can see here, I'm just typing A, B, C. And of course then on the left-hand side, you can change any of the style elements for any text that you've got selected. And take a note at the top here, we've got the breadcrumbs navigation. So this will tell you where you are within your project. And of course, all the details for the text styling are in this panel, including positioning, italics, letter spacing, line height, and various other parameters like the background and the positioning of your text container. So let's make some changes. Now let's start by selecting some headings, and let's change the font for not just one heading, but all the headings within your ebook. So clicking on the dot, dot, dot opens the menu so you can see what type of text it is. And at the top there, you can see you click make changes to all elements, and clicking the font drop down, then I can select a new font. And if I want to open my Google font selection, I can click on more fonts, or I can select the font that I want to choose. And it will make that change not just to that individual heading, but to all the headings throughout the whole ebook. So I can do the same, not just for that heading 2, but also for the heading 1, for the actual ebook title 2. And anywhere within the ebook that heading is used, again, that will get changed to whatever font that you just selected. Now let's cover adjusting spacing. So for example, let's look at images. So here's an image here, and you can see the space between the image and the text following it is very, very small. And in fact, I've just noticed that this is for all images within the project. So really what I want to do is adjust the spacing under not just this image, but all images, so I can end up with a nice margin there. So again, I'll go to the top and select make changes to all images, open the spacing option, and then just adjust the bottom margin just by a few pixels, and you can see it moving down like that. And then if I scroll down a bit further, then I can see the same change has been made to the other image. So next, let's cover headers and footers. So headers and footers are on by default for every project, but you can change the color or the text within a header or footer. In fact, you can even make it white or transparent, so it will effectively disappear. So just click the make changes to all elements and select a background color. For example, let's select a light gray, but you could select white and it will effectively not even be there. But of course, we select such a light color, we need to now change the font. So again, I'll just select the font, change the color, and it'll do that. And it'll do that for all the headings throughout the whole project. Now here's an issue that a lot of customers have, and that is they want to make changes to the text for heading. And on some pages, they want to make the text apply to just that page, and sometimes they might want the text to apply globally. And so there's an option here that if you select the text that you want to apply to your whole project, you can open its menu and select this icon here. It says apply text to all headers, and it will take that text and duplicate it on every single page. And you can also do exactly the same thing for footers as well. So now let's add some images to our project. So on the left side here, if I click on images, it will open a box saying suggested images. And the suggestion here is based on the tags you entered when you first started your project. But you can type in a simple keyword and it will automatically run a search. And you can look for horizontal, vertical or square images, all coming from Unsplash. And just grabbing an image and placing it anywhere within your project, it'll copy that image and insert it within the text. And the image will automatically be locked to that position. So essentially it's relative to the text where you've placed it. But of course you can drag and drop it and move it around the text. You can also do various things like do word wrap, or in fact just leave it in between two paragraphs, just like this. So the word wrap controls are on the left-hand side under attributes. And if you click on word wrap, you can see that now it's wrapped throughout the actual text. And of course, just clicking on the right justification will change the position. But here's a key point where if you now want to have an image that's not locked to the text, but locked to the actual page, again, select the image and instead of the attribute, select the positioning menu and the option move item freely around the page. And that will unlock it from the text, but lock it to the actual page. So now it's independent to the text and it can be positioned freely anywhere on that page. But do bear in mind that there is a risk that text could overlap, or it could overlap text. So do watch out for that if you're reformatting or adding text later on in the editing process. Of course, you can also add your own images, and so you can upload images. You can also organize them using folders. And we're going to use an example here where you can not only move existing images from your search to different folders, but let's also add a logo and add a watermark. So I'll create a folder called logo, and I'll move an icon from the images into the logo folder like this. And as you can see, this is the designer logo. And so what I'll do is now drag that into position. Now by default, it's locked to the text, so it moves the text down. But in this case, I'm going to go back and I'm going to click on move item freely around the page because I want to put this icon on the header. And now we're just going to show a really great trick where you can right click on that icon and select clone to every page, and it will duplicate that icon on every page throughout your ebook. Now let's cover adding that same icon as a watermark. So again, I'll go to images and I'll drag my logo onto the page. Again, by default, it will move the text around it. But I can then click move item freely around the page. But then I need to alter not just the size, but I need to push it back behind the text because this is going to be a watermark. So I'll open the menu for that image, which is just above it. And I'll select one of these icons here where I can move it back a layer. So I'm going to send it to the back behind the text. So now it's behind the text. All I need to do is adjust the opacities. In other words, I want to fade it out so it's just really faint, just like a watermark. And so you can see now it's just sitting there faintly behind the text on the page. And now if I right click and select clone to every page, it will now put that watermark on every page just like that. So now let's add an icon from Iconfinder. And so to do that, I'm going to go to the artwork and shapes section and click on icons. And again, I'm prompted by the tags that I've used when creating my project, but I could search over anything and simply drag and drop an icon that I want to use. And I can position this. This is based on a page position. So I can position this anywhere on the page, and it can also be cloned in exactly the same way. So now let's create a page break. So I can simply click on the plus icon above any page and choose what type of page I want to insert. So if I insert a regular page, then this is effectively a page break. And then I can drag a paragraph onto the blank page and simply type over the placeholder and add some text. One point to note is you can't copy and paste into a raw text box. Instead, what you should do is use the insert content feature and select copy and paste. And I'll show you that right now. So you get to this from the right navigation and select import content. And then this is where you can import any new content, but you can also click on copy and paste. And here is where you'd paste in your content if you're copying content from another ebook or Word document, for example. One of the powerful features in Designrr is you're able to undo and also access revisions. So undo is from a little icon here in the bottom left, and that will take you back step by step and undo actions that you've taken. But where the real power is in an area called revisions, which is accessed here. And this is where we do periodic autosaves to our server. And you can go back 7 revisions to a previous version. You can have a look at it to make sure it's the version that you actually want back. And once you scan through it and you're happy with it, click on revert. And if you've lost, for example, your internet connection or something's happened, your browser's crashed or whatever, and you need to start again, all your projects are saved on your local browser as well. So you can access them just there. You can also access help and support via the left menu. And you can also access our support help desk using this icon here. And that's the end of this short video on the top 10 tips for the design editor.